guys. It's Uncle Stitch. Welcome to Moonlight with Uncle Stitch. We are in a golf cart. And there's a place I'm going to be taking you guys that I might take you guys. I don't know yet. I gotta judge the neighborhood and see if people are awake or not. It's a very evil and sinister place, but it's beautiful. Especially at nighttime. So the hour's about 1 o'clock in the morning, like 1:15. Basically, I'm hoping that when we get, this is a very special place to me, but I'm hoping that when we get down there, that there's nobody going to be awake, because they probably will call the cops on us. But I'm just going to kind of gauge for myself and see. So this place that we're going, I would love to flip at this place. It's a bridge. It's a big, long wooden bridge that leads to a dock. And people have found dead bodies back there, and the problem is, you know, every place that I go, I try to capture that place before I leave with a flipping video. My old channel got shut down, and I lost a lot of those places. I would love to flip at this place, because it's just beautiful back there. But so I'm hoping that there's still the dock on the left hand side that has this long pole that kind of comes up and loops around, and at the bottom of the droop it's got this bluish green light. It's very sinister looking. But we're about to drive down here and see. We gotta make sure that there aren't any lights on. By the way, if anybody sees this golf cart down there, they're gonna call the cops, especially at this hour. But this place is pretty cool, and I wanted you guys to see it. Can't really see the environment. I can't tell if
it's real or not. Put up this fucking, I don't know if you guys can see it, it's like a owl. So I'm glad the vegetation has not overgrown the dock. It is close, but down here in Florida we have fucking brown recluses. We've got banana spiders that are the size of softballs. Just all kinds of nasty shit. And I would absolutely love to flip at this location. And it's not the water that's the problem. Or dropping the knife in the water. It's the fact that this place is infested with alligators. And most of the time, somebody put up a bunch of these fucking little owls. It's hard to see in the dark. The reel or not. So we're reaching the end of the dock here. I'll zoom. I'm gonna pop off and zoom in on one spot. Actually, I don't know if you guys can see. Moonlight's not enough. Just, I don't know if my phone's gonna pick it up, but let me try wiping the lens. So there's the moon, and there's like this fucking, you can't really see it for shit, but there's a ring that goes around the whole fucking moon. You can just barely pick it up right there. And just barely pick it up on the phone, but it's evident as fuck using like human eyes and shit, you know, not through a camera lens. I'm gonna switch it back. But yeah, way back when I was about 16, well, man, I might have been 15 and a half, and we first moved down here, I used to walk down to this dock and write poetry. And, as you can tell, the wildlife is very loud here, but, it would make a beautiful, place to flip, that's for sure, but, the camera lens doesn't capture the beauty of this place. You know? I just realized that I'm holding my fucking phone right side up, so this video is gonna be sideways. It's gonna have to be, otherwise you won't get a full screen. So, there we go. If I hold my phone right side up, it makes that little tiny video or whatever. You know what I mean? I'm going to try taking a picture of this fucking moon and seeing if it comes out any clearer, because I want you guys to see this. Unfortunately, the pictures aren't just, they're just not going to happen, but maybe when the sky is crystal clear, it'll come out better. But there's like a ring that goes around the moon that's like super fucking cool to look at. Like, especially if you used to play Halo back in the day. It's kind of reminds you of that. It's pretty cool. Yeah, there's a light on in one of the trailers. Basically what happens is homeless meth heads need a place to sleep, so they park their fucking cars down here, and anybody that parks down here gets the cops called on them, And there has been dead bodies that have been found back here. So they've been found floating around in the fucking water and shit, and the alligators have chomped their limbs off, and bad situation. I wish the camera was decent enough that I could show you how high up I am right now. I'm probably about 30 feet above the water. This little bridge that leads out to that dock goes up pretty damn high. I'll have to show you during daylight. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and shut this off and see you back at the house here in a minute. What up, dudes? So, as long as the audio is good, I will include the golf cart footage. But if it's not, then I'll have to remake it. There's a lot of memories here. I never had a sister or anything growing up, so I never really understood how obnoxiously protective people are. And when I moved down here is when I finally got the gist of it. My parents had a friend that they knew from Ohio. And this friend who lived here had a son who was married to this one chick. And this one chick had two daughters. He did not have kids of his own. He was cool as shit. She wasn't. She was a bitch. Her name was Katrina. The wife of the dude. The other guy, the dude that was married to her, his name was Mike. And, the daughter's name, though, in particular one, they had two. One of them was like 9. Her name was Kayla. And the other one was my age. Her name was Rika. And, I was about 16 and she was 16. And all we ever did was talk. There was nothing. We never kissed. I never asked her out on a date. Nothing happened. Literally fucking nothing. I mean, this chick, even if I wanted to, which I didn't, she was just gone. You know what I mean? She lived a very structured life in a private school, and I was not a very law-abiding person at the time, I'll say that. There was no friction between us. The only thing that was between us was that our parents knew each other. And I'm trying to do something about the lighting here, but I'm not going to blind myself. There we go. I'm trying to set this up so you guys can see my face. But, we'd go over there every now and again for bullshit. Just fucking, play cornhole or, whatever bullshit occasion was going on. And Rika's father, who both her daughters had no idea, but both their mom and their dad smoked pot. Unfortunately, Mike ended up getting cancer,
And that dude worked his ass off until the day he died. He did not spend a day in that house without working on something. That's just the way he was. He was a good man. But we were at a Thanksgiving party one time. My family was there. My parents, my grandparents, a lot of their friends and their families. I mean, we're talking at least 30 people that were at this house. It was a decent sized house, but they were renting it. They didn't own it. Month to month. And the reason why they were renting it month to month is because it was actually up for sale, but it was so expensive nobody could fucking afford it. So they were renting it for basically what the utility bill was. Because they knew that person. They knew the person who owned it. So that's how they got that deal. It was a beautiful home. Had a big dock on it. Had a lanai over the swimming pool. It was an in-ground swimming pool. It's a beautiful place. That's for what, if you don't know what a lanai is, it's kind of, some people call it a bird cage. It's just wire mesh that is in the shape of a house that goes over like a swimming pool or something, or a patio or whatever. But, so Thanksgiving rolls around, and I'll tell you about the Thanksgiving before this one, because I was on my best fucking behavior here. But we were playing, like, me, Rika, and Kayla, and somebody else, I think Frankie, we were playing Wii Bowling in the fucking living room, right? We're surrounded by adults. And her mom was so paranoid that, you know, her mom was so paranoid that something was going to happen to her. And she never took her eyes off me from the time I stepped in that house to the time we sat down and ate dinner at the same table. And we were just playing Wii Bowling and talking and laughing, and Rika was like, hey, I gotta show you this. And she pulls out some bullshit artwork that she did. And I'm like, oh, wow, that's great. You know, whatever. Just, when you first move to places, you know, it gets pretty lonely. Unless you start making friends. And that's all that was there. It was just somebody to speak to. That's all that was. There was nothing there between us. And I keep mentioning that. But, for a reason. So we sit down to this freaking wonderful Thanksgiving dinner, and, I fill up my plate with turkey and mashed potatoes, and, you know, they had gravy there, but we're a German family, and this is something that's very misunderstood. We don't put gravy on our mashed potatoes. We put ketchup. Our mashed potatoes, and it's good as fuck. It's awesome. And for people who get grossed out by it, I always tell them, like, hey, you know, do you ever dip your french fries in ketchup? Because it's the same thing. And they're like, it is not the same thing. Well, that's just how I grew up, you know. So I had a big plate of mashed potatoes, green beans, and asparagus. Good asparagus, the kind that was cooked in tinfoil on a grill. Good asparagus. And, you know, I had all the fucking fixings. And I sit down at the table, and, you know, everybody's getting their food, and they're all sitting down, and Mike stands up at the end of this huge, long wooden table, about 20 feet long. Made out of mahogany. That table was probably worth more than most of the houses that I've lived in. But, sorry, my light here also doubles as an ashtray. But,
So Mike stands up and he says, "Grace." And after he gets done with the prayer, Katrina knew that I drank. She knew that. The whole family knew that. Everybody knew that. It was obvious as fuck. And I didn't even bother trying to hide it. So I went out to my car. I got a bottle of Jack Daniels. I filled up my glass with Jack Daniels with a brim. Walked inside. And then that's when I started gathering my food. And it stank. I mean, you could smell Jack Daniels in that whole house. But, so, about 30 seconds after Mike gets done saying grace, out of nowhere, you know, I'm like sticking my fork in the turkey, getting ready to for my first taste. And, she says, "Why don't you just get the fuck out of my house?" And I was like, "What the hell?" And, I looked over at Rika, and I was like, you know, like, what the fuck's going on here? And then I looked over at Mike, and Mike was like he just had his hands over his eyes. He was just shaking his head. And she's like, "You're not welcome here anymore. Get the fuck out." And if you know me as a person, when men do stuff like that to me, I have a very different reaction than when women do stuff like that to me. You know, if a man does that to me, I'm going to be like, "The fuck's your problem, dude?" You know, like, if you want to fight, you know, I mean, shit. All you had to do was ask, you know. But with women, you can't do that type of thing, too, so... rather than let the situation grow, whatever situation was there, I decided to leave. And I later found out that she thought that I was trying to hook up with her daughter. And I'm like, you embarrassed me in front of 30 fucking people. All of them are friends of my family, and now they're all probably thinking that I'm some kind of a fucking pervert. And secondly, even if there was something going on between us, it would have been okay. I mean, it's not like, you know, either one of us were adults. You know what I'm saying? But I never even kissed her, you know? I never asked her out on a date or anything. We were just mutual, what I refer to as neutral factions. That's a weird way of looking at relationships, but that's how I separate relationships, is, you know, bad factions, good factions, neutral factions. Sometimes I refer to the bad as red factions. Sometimes I refer to the good as green factions, so on and so forth. But, so there, well, actually, it might have been like two Thanksgivings before that one. Let me tell you what a disaster this was. So, my brother had gotten out of jail, and he moved into my grandparents' house. Because he wasn't welcome at my parents' house. And, you know, I was, at that time, I was drunk every single day. For as long as I could be. I mean, there was no sober moment unless it was, I was at work. I mean, if I was not at work, I was fucking wasted. And, so, I get this phone call,
one day out of the ordinary. I go home, my parents aren't there, and I'm like, what the fuck? We had some kind of a work release program where, like, if you chose to go learn a career or something, you could get out of school, like, early, like, at noon instead of 3 or something. And I was working for a tool and die company that produced diamond tip drill bits for Lockheed Martin. And this company was going to send me to college to learn CNC machining, computer network control machining, and make me a machinist. And they were, as soon as I got out of college, my starting pay was going to be $80,000 a year. I had a great career with this company, you know what I'm saying? And just out of nowhere, I get this fucking phone call. And my grandmother's like, hey, you gonna come down for Thanksgiving, you know? And I was like, Thanksgiving? Oh, shit. Completely fucking forgot about it. And I was wasted off my ass. So I get in my car. I drove 60 fucking miles down to my grandmother's house. And this is like, I am blind, stinking drunk, blackout fucking drunk. And I got a bottle of Evan Williams with me, a big 1.75 liter bottle of Evan Williams. So as soon as I get there, I come da-da-da-da-da, knocking on the door. And I go in and I find out, you know, like, Thanksgiving hasn't really started yet. You know, we're all just kind of hanging out. I'm like, okay, great. So I go back out to the, I grab a glass, I go out to the fucking truck and pour a big tall glass of Evan Williams. And as I'm walking towards the house again, my mom walks outside. She's like, yeah, that's what I thought. I figured you brought booze with you. She's like, I don't want you drinking here tonight. I was like, why not? And she was like, well, because there's people here that are church-going people that are friends with your grandparents, that this would be a bad thing. I respected her wishes. So I poured Coca-Cola in my glass of Evan Williams to make it look like I was drinking Coca-Cola. So my grandmother, I walked into this kitchen, and I mean, I'm like on the verge of blacking the fuck out. And my grandmother's sitting in the kitchen, and she's like, she's making deviled eggs. And she's cutting them down the middle, and she's taking out all the yolks and putting them in a bowl. And she looks at me and she's like, do you like deviled eggs? And I said, oh yeah, not really. I didn't really like deviled eggs. And she takes this wooden spoon about, you know, half the size of my face, and sticks it in the mayonnaise jar and just whack! Just slaps it in the bowl of this fucking, you know, a bunch of oaks. And just starts squeezing mustard in there and, you know, twirling it around and shit and breaking it all up. And I about threw up. Just the thought of all that mayonnaise. Just, ugh. I mean, when I put mayonnaise on a sandwich, it's thin as fuck. If I do get mayonnaise on a sandwich. Because I'm not that big of a fan. But, so anyway, I walk out into the living room, and I'm sitting there and I'm listening to all these people talk, and I'm like, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna have a good time. And my mom walks up to me and she's like, what is that? And I was like, it's Coca-Cola. And she's like, bullshit. And she's like, I can smell it. And I was like, so I walked into the bathroom, right, and I hear all these plates clattering around. And I'm just sitting in there drinking, you know, texting people on the phone, you know, trying to finish my drink. And all of a sudden I hear somebody say, Zach, you ready? And so I chugged what was left in the glass. And I go out there, and there's all these people around the table. And we had it outside on a picnic table that they had, that my grandfather built. And set the turkey in the middle. And I happen to be sitting in the fucking middle, if you know where this is going already. So my dad stands up. My grandfather's like, would you like to do the honors? And so my dad stands up and he says, Dear Lord, Heavenly Father. It's just, it all hit me at once, dude. It all hit me at once. Like, there was no warning. There was no warning at all. I just went, all over the fucking turkey. All over the food. Oh my God. That they had spent fucking hours cooking. And it wasn't just like a regular puke. It was like an apocalypse puke. It was like a demonic possessioning. Projectile puke. So, you know, if Katrina knew where I came from, she would have seen how polite I was truly being. But I know that I am far from normal. And so is my family. But, there's all kinds of shit like that. I'm gonna have to redo, some of the story time with Uncle Stitches. But... you know, I'm going to probably put them all in one video. I'm going to try to. This is kind of a long video, but I'll try to put it in a long video and make a Uncle's story time with Uncle Stitches about the time, you know, when my family thought I was dead, and then they found out that I'd been on a binge for like 7 days. Or what I thought was 7 days, and ended up being on a binge for like a couple of weeks. But I had completely lost track of time. There were several times where that had happened, where my parents had to call the police and file a missing police report because I wasn't answering my phone and I wasn't answering my door for weeks at a time. But that's neither here nor there. I will tell those stories, and so they sound horrible right now, but they are fucking hilarious from my point of view. But anyway, so I'll probably do Moonlight with Uncle Stitches while I'm down here in Florida a couple more times, tell some more stories and stuff. And, you know, I'm sober now. I haven't been drinking anything, any liquor, no beer, nothing. So it's a different world. It's more definitely more clear, I'll say. But it's nice not being broke as fuck all the time. So there's that too. But all right, guys, good night. We'll catch you later. Peace.